There's no real beginning to this story. No piece of pie, say you. I didn't find the leading force in my life on the stage of my ballet performance when I was 5. I didn't discover my hidden talent when I was pushed on the stage with a guitar when I was 11. I didn't unleash my cutthroat writing abilities when I joined journalism my freshman year. I didn't raise $1,000 with my Invisible Children Club my senior year. I haven't done anything of any major significance. I started high school with nothing really to my name, but a decision to join publications. I met some cool people that I thought I could be like when I was as old as them. They were the kind of people that had that amazing creative talent that literally won them award after award, and they all worked marvelously together. All it took for me was to show a little interest, or be the only one to show a little interest for that matter, and by the time I was as old as them, the job was mine. I was news editor and head photographer of the Blue and Gold my junior year. Being that one of our main goals that year was to get everyone in the newspaper, I was everywhere on campus getting photos of these people doing their thing. You probably saw me there. I got photos of all the important people on campus. It quickly became my hobby. I spent the whole year putting everyone else in the spotlight, examining what makes them tick, how they discovered what makes them them, how they found out what they were going to do for the rest of their lives and why they love doing it, and blah, blah, blah. I couldn't figure out how all these people knew where they were going in life. They had a talent that drove them forward and gave them inspiration. I didn't even like being a newspaper anymore. I hated it, actually. I wasn't good at it. Not like these people were. How can I be involved in so many things my whole life but never really enjoy it or have any talent at it? My insecurities and unsureness of myself took over, and eventually I hit a stage in my life that I never want to look at again. So what now? How does anyone know where to go from here? Do you go back and evaluate everything you did wrong? That would just throw me over the edge even deeper. I already had people there to remind me every day about how I was such an idiot, and believe me, they showed no mercy. Room 303 quickly became my home base. I threw myself into work, being involved in newspaper, beginning advanced broadcast, along with other extracurricular activities. Broadcast was another thing I hated, and I thought I would love it. So all I had was photography. I grew more artistic in my technique, being inspired by past head photographers as well as world-renowned photographers. I still wanted to do something important like the people in these photos were doing, though. It took a while, but I realized I was doing something important. How would these people get recognized if there weren't someone taking beautiful photos of them like this? You wouldn't know what he looks like if you never saw a photo of him. Who would have thought I could turn a hobby into a passion, into a career? It took a while and a lot of self-growth, but I finally got my act together and slowly went back to the way I was before all this mess. I got rid of all the people that put negativity in my life, or the graduation did it for me, and I actually started hanging out with my friends again. I joined a class I thought I could actually get good use out of my newly discovered talent, and I got better at this design thing. But most importantly, I'm happy again, and I know where I'm going. I worked so hard, and I got into college, Long Beach State, whoop whoop. And I know what I want to do, too, be a photographer. I am going to do something of significance, take pictures of important people while still being recognized as an important person myself. Who knows, I may spark a revolution, too. Now all I have to do is figure out if I want to start my own business, work for a newspaper. Wait, am I crazy? Do you freelance or travel for a magazine? I'm just glad I have the options. I'm glad I have a story. I'm glad I get to put a sentence at the end of this saying what I learned and how it can help you. So here it is. If you haven't found that leading force, discovered that hidden talent, or found your clear defining moment, you haven't realized it's as easy as doing exactly what you've enjoyed doing every day until you saw this. So that's it. It may not have much of a beginning, but it sure is one hell of an ending. And this is the ending, but I'm definitely ready for it now. In the end, I get to take the photo and be in it too. The faster we're falling.